Hello, you're watching Proactive London. United Oil and Gas Chief Executive Brian Larkin has hailed the exceptional performance of its Abu Senan license in Egypt, but the company and its partners are currently addressing a water cut issue that's affecting production. Brian joins me now. Brian, good to speak with you today.
Good morning, Stephen, and firstly, apologies for the backdrop. I'm unusually in a hotel room. I normally do these interviews in my office, but I'm traveling this week. I'm in London for various PRIO meetings, but it's a pleasure to talk this morning.
And good to have you in London. But Brian, stepping back to yesterday's announcement, the company's changed its production guidance. Can you explain what this means for the ASH field and also United Oil and Gas?
Yeah, sure. Well, we previously guided that we would produce between 2,500 and 2,700 barrels of oil for this year. What's actually transpired is the ASH field, where we have three producing wells. One of them has, we've seen an increase in water cut. That's not unusual. You normally have water in a well, but what tends to happen over the life of a well is as you produce the oil, the water cut increases. What's happened with ASH 2 is that the water cut has increased higher and quicker than anticipated. So whilst it's a disappointment in that we've had a higher water cut, the reality is the well has really exceeded our pre-drill expectations that we had over 18 months ago. And in fact, we've made over five times money back on the well. So it is disappointing. We are disappointed, but we are carrying out a number of remedial works at the minute. And this is by certainly no means the end of the ASH field. ASH will remain in production. It'll just be at a much lower rate. And hopefully those remedial works that I mentioned can reduce that water cut going forward.
Can you elaborate on how this news impacts the company's strategy, Brian?
Sure. It has no impact upon the company's strategy whatsoever. Our operational, commercial, financial, M&A, technical strategy remains exactly the same. We're fully funded for all of our upcoming activity. And in fact, we've, as we announced yesterday as well, we've also added an additional well to this year's drilling program. So there's no impact whatsoever on the longer term strategy for the company.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you also announced intervention options during the shareholder call yesterday, Brian. What confidence do you have in your forward guidance?
We're very confident in our forward guidance. And I think once we really got our hands around the issue, we had a deep understanding of what the forward guidance would look like. And that forward guidance is based on what we know today. It doesn't take into account the current well we're drilling, and it doesn't take into account the development well that we're also announced that we'd add to the program yesterday. But again, just to reiterate, it's not unusual to get water cut in wells. It happens. It happens all the time. What is a little bit unusual about this and what is disappointing is that it has happened quicker than we would have anticipated. But, you know, as I've mentioned on the upside, we have had five times money back on this well. So there's a lot to be grateful for on it. I think from our own perspective, you hope that such large production flow rates continue a lot longer. But, you know, such is the nature of the industry. Sometimes these things happen. But, you know, we get on with managing the assets.
Brian, take us to that second well that you're drilling. Can you explain why?
Well, we had the current well we're drilling at the minute is an exploration well, and we had considered that to be the last one for this year. But over the course of the last number of months, we had decided that potentially, given that oil prices sustained at high level, we had a rig on contract, we had the cash to do it, perhaps it wouldn't be such a bad idea to drill another development well. So we had been considering that alongside our partners and the operator in Kuwait. In fact, there's a workshop with our partners next week in Cairo to agree a final target on what we will drill. But we decided that it would be sensible right now to add another well to this program, which will be our fifth well this year, which, you know, is absolutely fantastic to have drilled five wells in 1 year. Fully funded, I might add, fully funded, which is important to add. You know, we haven't, as a company, been back to the market to raise equity to fund any operations in nearly 2 years. And to have been able to have drilled so much during that period, I think is a real testament to the quality of the assets that we've got now.
Mm. I mean, while you're speaking about assets you've got, you made another announcement today, and that's the signing of your UK Central North Sea licenses to Quattro Energy Limited. How does this divestment affect your cash position, Brian?
Well, firstly, firstly, we don't discuss our cash position. As we said, we hosted a shareholder call yesterday, and as we mentioned on the shareholder call, and as we've continuously said, we don't discuss our project our cash position. But you know, I think first and foremost, asset divestment is a core part of our long-term development strategy for the company. We have a track record in doing that. Once we've created value in an asset, and at the appropriate time, we will divest that asset and use those proceeds to reinvest those proceeds back in the growth of the business. And so obviously very pleased to announce the signing of the binding SPA this morning with Quattro. We've also got two other divestments which are ongoing. The first one obviously being the assets in the North Sea, which is the Maria and Zeta discovery. That is a divestment which we've also announced. Or sorry, not the Maria and Zeta, the Selva divestment in Italy, which we've also announced. And we're hopeful that that deal will also complete before the end of the year. In addition to that, we're also waiting on the latest installment of the Crown payment. So there's portfolio management is critical and crucial to our strategy. And I go back to my point earlier, because of portfolio management, not just in terms of investments, but also managing our existing asset base, we haven't had to go back to the market for quite a long time. I'm very proud of that. And we will continue. That will continue to be a key part of our development strategy.
Brian, what should shareholders expect from United Oil and Gas going forward?
Well, in the short immediate term, we've obviously drilled an exploration well at the minute, so we are a number of weeks away from a well result there. We'll also announce the new development well. We've said we're going to go and drill a new well, but we haven't announced the target. We will announce that once we've completed our technical workshop next week in Cairo and also agreed a forward program with our operator and the rig contractor. We would also have the UK divestment completion to announce. We'll have the Italian divestment to announce also. And alongside that, then we also have we're also going to continue to explore various M&A opportunities between now and the end of the year and into next year. And then alongside that, of course, we've also got our Jamaica asset, and at the appropriate time, we'll update the market on that as well.
So sounds like a really busy period. I'm sure you'll keep us abreast of all those developments, but thank you very much for speaking to us today.
My pleasure.
That's Brian Larkin. He's Chief Executive of United Oil and Gas.